Okay, a top-end rebuild on an Evolution 1994 Evolution bike with a 1996 engine in it, XLH 1200 Sportster. Not an auto electrician for cars or motorbikes. I'm not a mechanic for cars or bikes either. I'm just somebody trying to fix my bike. At this stage, the heads have been done. The valves have been ground. The head's been cleaned up. New valve seals. The pistons are in the bore, and they've got new rings on them. I've ground the valves and I've got adjustable push rods coming. I'll be using the push rod covers that came with the bike, not the removable ones, so I've got something in mind to get the length of the push rod right. They're the stock ones. Oh, by the way, I took out these valve seals and I put in the better quality ones, the ones with the blue rubber gasket type situated over the top of the valve seal. So right now the gudgeon pins are in the freezer. They've been in the freezer for about 24 hours. I won't be removing this rag in the crankcase until I've got the gudgeon pin in and just about to seat the cylinder. I got the gasket off mainly with paint stripper, but be careful with paint stripper, it burns very hard and very fast. The threads have got a light coating of motor oil on them. Okay, so I've got the dowel pin just there, and there's that hole there and that hole there, so I'll just put the gasket on. It should line up. So in that case, I've got a ridge around the top here. This points up, and you can see there it's pointing down. And so I'll just install this the same way. Just going to make sure that there is nothing waiting to fall down there when I get the rag out. Now, I've just hit the piston down, but the hole is very close to where the first ring is, so if you hit it out a fraction too far, the rings will come out the bottom there. Then you'll have to get your ring compressor, compress the ring and drive it back up and readjust it. Okay, I've got my gudgeon pins, and they've been in the freezer for more than 24 hours. I've got them labelled up where they came from. This is, as far as I know, a 1996 XLH engine. Now the rear piston did face backwards, so there's the arrow, and that's facing the back of the bike. That's how it was when I took it off. I've previously labelled the rear piston, rear, and put an R for the rear of the rear cylinder. So on the front cylinder, we've got the arrow pointing forward, and I've labelled previously the front of the barrel with an F. Okay, so let's drive the piston out. Got to be really careful because there's very little tolerance between the gudgeon pin hole and the first ring that'll pop out. So there's the hole there for the gudgeon pin, and that's it. So I'll turn the piston square onto the ball. Okay, what I'm going to try and do is move the gudgeon pin so that the gap, or the two ends, are located on either side of this dish here. Okay, it's moving around, and there it is,